Namaste. Today we are going to study about lenses. We are seeing the world around us with the help of our eyes, which is a good example of lens. With the help of eye lens, we are enjoying the world around us, right? So it is necessary, it is very, very important to understand about this lens. That is why we are studying the lens here. What is a lens? Suppose here two spherical surfaces are given. This is a sphere and this is another sphere. Okay. These two spheres, when you cut the part of this sphere and cut this part of the sphere and bound it together, you will get the shape like this, right? This is what is called a convex lens. The convex lens is thick at the center and thin at the top. This is how the lenses are made. The two surfaces of a spherical, that is, we bound the two surfaces of a spherical surface together, we will get a convex lens. Mainly there are convex lens and concave lens. In addition to that, we are getting spherical, plano concave, plano convex, concavo convex, that is mixed with plane and concave, plane and convex. Like that you will get many type of lenses, but the main two lenses we are discussing here is convex lens and concave lens. This is how convex lens is formed. How this concave lens is formed? When we are taking the sphere like this and another sphere like this, okay, we cut the portion and bound it together here. Then you will get the concave lens of the form like this. Okay, this is your concave lens. Right. When we are talking about the sphere has one center, right? That center we call it as center of curvature. Let this be C1 and let this be C2. This is what is called center of curvature. Here also, when we cut the convex lens or concave lens, one center is there for the lens. That center is called optical center. First of all, we have to understand the terms associated with lenses. One is optical center. Optical center is nothing but the center of the lens. Okay. For example, let me draw the lens here. And this center is called the optical center. This area, that is this much area of the lens, is exposed to light where refraction is possible. And that surface which is exposed or where refraction is taking place is called the aperture. Aperture. The area of the lens exposed to light. And the center of curvature. What is center of curvature? It's the center of the sphere in which lens is a part. Okay. And here in the case of lenses, we are having two center of curvature. That is, we are binding the surface of two spheres. Each one has its own center, and so we have two focus. This lens is a transparent medium. What do you mean by transparent medium? The medium through which the passage of light is possible. Light can pass through is called a transparent medium. Then next comes the line passing through the optical center. Any line passing through the center is called the axis, that you know very well. And similarly, this is the main axis passing through the center of the lens and is called principal axis. Principal axis is the line passing through the center of curvature and optical center of a lens. Next comes principal focus. Let me draw the lens here. This is a convex lens. This is the principal axis passing through optical center. Suppose a ray parallel to the principal axis. Here, ray parallel to the principal axis, what happens to this ray? Gets refracted and falls here. Here also, the ray gets refracted and converges a point here on the principal axis. See here, all the rays are meet at a point here in the case of a convex lens. That is why this convex lens is called as a converging lens. All the light rays meet at a point, converged at a point, so that convex lens is called as a converging lens. Convex lens, converging lens. And this point where all the rays after refraction, the rays parallel to the principal axis after refraction meet at a point called the principal focus. This is another term associated with lenses. Principal focus. And what do you mean by focal length? Focal length means a distance of the focus. From where? From the optical center. Okay. From the optical center to principal focus, a length is there. That length is called focal length. Here we are taking or we are placing the object on the left side. That is why the refraction is taking place in this way. If we are taking the object on the right side, the refraction is taking place here and you will get another focal point here. That is why the lenses have two foci. They have two foci. And in addition to the center of curvature we know 2F, right? R is equal to 2F. So instead of C1 and C2, we call it as 2F1 and 2F2. This is how the refraction is taking place in the case of convex lens. Suppose we are taking concave lens. Concave lens means this type, thin at the middle and thick at the edges. This is the principal axis. And the ray, what happens to this ray? This ray refracted in this way. In this way. And we are getting a virtual point here. This virtual point is the focus of concave lens. That is, when the refraction is taking place from the left side. This is possible from this side also. That is why concave lens have also two foci. When it is taking place from here, you will get a foci here. And when it is taking place from here, you will get a foci here. This is how the refraction is taking place in concave lens. And the distance here from the focus to the optical center here also called as focal length. These are the terms associated with concave lens and convex lens. So you here also some rules are there associated with the refraction. Let us see what are the rules associated with refraction. First one, this is the convex lens. And this is the principal axis, right? The ray parallel to the principal axis after refraction pass through the point called F. Pass through the point F. That is the first rule. The ray parallel to the principal axis after refraction pass through the focus. What is the second rule? The reversibly we can say how the ray passing through the focus becomes parallel to the principal axis, right? The ray passing through the focus, let this be the focus here, and the ray passing through the focus like this, what happens to this ray? Becomes parallel to the principal axis. That is the second rule. These are all rough diagrams. I am not using the scale, so some bending will be there for the diagram. That you excuse me for that. Just you take the scale and draw the diagram when you are studying the rules. The next one is the ray passing through the optical center. The ray passing through the optical center go without any deviation, go straight. These are the three rules associated with the lenses when we are drawing the ray diagram. So study these rules well and we can do the ray diagrams in the next class. Thank you for watching. Keep on watching my video till the end. Go through there is a continuity between the videos. So you go through the previous videos also, then only you will get an idea of my classes. So thank you for watching. See you next time.